Okay.
Alright, so...
Okay, there we go. It's up and loading.
On Twitch, though.
It's going to take a minute. When it's okay. When it's green in the bottom right corner, you see where it says the number kilobytes per second, and it's green.
Yeah.
That's
1,000.
Yeah,
1,234.
Yeah, that's usually what indicates that you're live.
Okay.
For those of you listening, Mr. Cotton is still new, so.
Yes, he's fresh meat.
Fleshling.
What the fuck? I should have cooked a little bit while I was doing that. Jesus, sorry. I'm gonna go get some more.
You're asking too much.
Alright. What I need to do is I need to go and get some redstone. That's what I need to do.
I have some if you come over to the house.
How much?
Give me 1 second.
Because I'm trying to make as many advanced circuits as I can, because advanced circuits are very important for this.
Where did I put them? I put them over here. Holy shit, hold on.
Alright. Is that the house?
Yeah, no, my dimensional border.
Okay, alright.
A stack of 64 here.
How much are you willing to part with? Let's do that.
Take it all, I guess. I have no use for it right now.
Okay.
I'm pretty sure whatever you're making, I'll end up using, so.
Yeah, it's just gonna.
Taking part in.
It's just gonna be some advanced circuits, because we're gonna need those.
Oh my god, you're okay.
Yeah, hi.
I didn't realize you would come in.
You didn't hear the pop?
I don't have a bell on my door.
There should be a pop every time that I come in. Listen.
I could. Oh, I was opening. I was opening.
It should.
Blend it in real fast.
It should sound like an Enderman came in, except there are no Endermen.
Yeah.
Which reminds me, I think I want to. Sorry. Go on.
Go ahead.
No, you go.
Are we still going to try and do another nether portal and try and put a nuclear reactor inside there and run stuff off of it?
Not nuclear reactor, dimensional door, but yeah, I'd like to.
Okay.
But what I'd like to do first is find out where the end is.
Where the end is?
Yeah.
What is that?
The end is basically where you find an ender dragon.
Yeah. You need to make an ender portal first.
No, you need to find a fortress first, which you can use Eye of Ender for. In order to make that, you need blaze powder, which I just got 21 blaze rod, and ender pearls, which as I've told you time and time again, we can make them. I'm kind of interested in doing that. Alright.
I would totally be up for doing
a little.
I've never once battled the Ender Dragon. I mean, I've seen it. Like, I've made an Ender Portal and gone to him.
Yeah, I can't say I've actually done it myself. I've always watched people do it, but I've never really done it myself or with a little adventure.
Adventure!
Okay.
The only thing is, once you get in there, I don't know if there's a way to.
Oh, you can. You can get out.
Okay, because, I mean, like, I...
There's, if you kill the end... There's, you fall out the world. And there's also, you kill the Ender Dragon, and right in the center is the portal.
Oh, okay.
But it only activates after you kill it. What am I looking for? I'm looking for iron. Let's get the mining stone.
Stop storytelling.
Yep, okay.
I'm still setting up. I got the title.
Oh,
but.
Okay.
Okay. Let us know when you're all set. I don't know why I'm stuttering.
Well, once I'm done with this story, by the way, I got another one.
Oh, joy.
Awesome.
All right.
I'm sure we all have some pretty good stories.
Yeah, we all do.
We've been telling it for like about an hour, so I'm sure we got some good ones.
Not an hour, more like 5 minutes. No, not 5 minutes. More like 15.
More like 30.
He was exaggerating, Andrew.
Shut up!
Correct him over it.
Motherfucker, I will do whatever the hell I want. You're not my mom! God!
Let me just be an ass!
The question about the, turtle.
Oh, what's up with the turtle?
Can it, fall?
Yes.
No.
What, fall? Like gravity fall?
If it falls, will it still keep going?
Yes.
Okay.
I've never seen one of the turtles fall before.
Okay, where am I?
I just wanna, test something. Because I'm gonna make another gate of hell and, kinda just hover it over. Set the coordinates and then, see what happens. Hopefully it won't break.
Hopefully.
Crossing our fingers.
I made way too many Eyevender.
I don't think you ever have too many.
You actually only need 9 at most. Oh, there. That one broke. By the way, I am looking for the fortress right now, but no telling how long this will take.
Oh, we're doing this now?
Well, I'm just going to try and see where it is.
Oh, okay.
Now I'm going through these things like it's fucking nothing. Thank you.
What is that?
Eight. Out of here. Oh,
there's a glitch.
All right, I got a better idea.
Ah, shit.
It seems to be this way, so I'll just run this way until... about here.
He's dead.
Ah, are you serious?
I am quite serious.
And don't call me Shirley.
Alright, Nancy.
Shut up.
Alright, Sarah.
Tara.
Okay, it's currently mining through air.
It'll do that. Oh, what? How did you die? Well, clearly you died then. What'd you do? What'd you do?
Fall in lava.
No, he didn't fall in lava. He burned.
Oh, I fell in lava.
Oh.
Oh, I fell in lava.
Oh, right.
I was removing this block. A pipe blocking the way. Of some lava, and I was removing the pipe so I could put something else there instead. But when I removed the pipe so I could go down and grab the pipe, I was like, oh, I could quickly jump down and grab the pipe and then get back out.
Oh.
No, you fucking retard! And then obviously the lava flowed in on top of me, and we all know what happened after that.
Yeah, you especially. Alright, where'd it go? Where'd it go? Is there... Did I find it?
Okay, streaming and...
Oh my god, I actually got some of the shit back. Awesome.
Yeah, epic! Found it! Alright, let's fly up for now. Breathe up. Down. Okay, found it. Alright. I'm actually glad that I found it that quickly. I'm gonna make a cobblestone mark.
Usually it takes a lot longer.
Actually, yeah. Then again, Ender pearls are a little bit more scarce than how we have it. So.
Wonder. Can I stand on the turtle?
Alright, I'm gonna make a waypoint to it.
I don't know.
I tried, it's hurting me.
what would it be called?
Get off me, bitch!
Alright, so if we're ever ready, just let me know and I'll get to work on
it. I'm just having some problems trying
to
open up this chat.
I'm gonna wanna make some quantum armor or something of
usefulness
to go in there.
Yeah, we're gonna have to start enchanting and shit too.
As I said, I'm more than happy to go in there, but
I don't wanna
go in there with just nothing.
I actually kinda wanna make this a team effort and see if we can get Eric in on this. Like, obviously, if we're gonna get Eric, it's not gonna be tonight, but
I don't know if he's going to be willing to do it, because he really doesn't like
the
fighting aspect of Minecraft.
He likes the creativity.
Yeah, like, he really likes just building shit.
I think that's probably why I took off PvP, then.
I don't think he actually knew what he was doing.
Okay. Well, really quick.
That's just an accident.
Okay, I'm streaming.
Alright. Really quick. Everyone, press C, and I'm going to read off these coordinates for you. Okay?
Hold on.
Alright. Is this the ender?
This is the fortress. We still have to explore it before we find the end.
Where are you? Are you in the normal world?
I'm in the normal world right now.
Okay.
Okay. Tell me when you're ready.
Alright, what's the...
Okay, X is negative 634.
634.
Set Y would do whatever the hell you want, because it's not going to matter in the end. So all set right. to 65 or something. And Z is 461. It is literally not that far away from the house.
What was it again? 461.
That. Z is 461, if you did not catch it.
Z is 461.
Let me repeat myself.
461, and what's Y?
Y can be anything, it doesn't matter.
65, just make it the same for everybody.
Yeah, 65, 64, doesn't matter. You could set it for 2, it's really...
An X?
X is... negative 634.
Okay.
It's off the coast of our little village there.
Oh, shit.
I think there's another fortress. I think there's a fortress, one per map.
Anyway, shall we start with our story time?
Yeah, we should do that.
Yes.
Since it's the reason why we started.
Yes.
For
the reason.
So
okay, I can't play this game full screen or else I'll fuck up everything. Okay. So. I've said this story earlier, but I'll say it again. So I was working one day. I typically clean the bathrooms, like I check in there every hour, see if everything's okay, and I find a pair of pants, socks, and underwear. And
now, is this the men's bathroom? Or the,
yes,
the girls'
it's
bathroom?
The men's bathroom.
Okay.
So, yeah, it's the men's bathroom. And typically what I do is that I kind of just leave it there to make sure if the person is not still in the store and he may have left it there for a reason.
Why? What would the reason possibly be?
I don't know.
Excuse me, I feel like drying my clothes here today.
Just fucking... how would the guy even approach customer service? Excuse me, yes, I believe I left my clothing here. Can I possibly get it back?
Awkward moment when you realize, oh, fuck.
Oh, I'm not wearing anything, shit.
So, the clothes were
kind of wet. I don't know why this isn't equipped.
So I guess he was just drying it there.
He pissed
okay,
himself.
First of all, when I came back, they were still there, so I had to take it to customer service.
Bye, Quinn. You left.
I left?
Apparently you left.
Yeah, you're out of the game. You just said you left.
Yeah, the game's frozen.
Alright, continue.
Yes. So I had to take it to customer service. So I kind of just awkwardly...
Boy, hell.
...carried these clothing, this, pants, underwear, and socks to the customer service so they could put it in lost and found. You know, and I had to pass through, the cafe the because this is where it was. So I'm holding these pants, walking out the bathroom, holding pants in front of people eating.
Oh, where is it? What type of places that you work? A store, a restaurant?
It's a grocery store with a cafe.
Ah.
Is it called Whole Foods? Just out of curiosity.
Well, technically it's called Green Life, but it's owned by Whole Foods.
What the fuck is that noise?
I feel like I know this company.
Yeah, it's the grocery store that sells healthy foods. So,
I'm trying to think if they have them here.
I don't think so, no.
It sounds so familiar, though. Like,
it's a very hipster place.
Are you a hipster?
No.
No.
I cannot consider myself a hipster because I play so many games.
So many games? Is that what you said?
Mainstream.
Oh, okay.
But, I have another story. And it didn't really happen to me. This story was just told to me, like, the first day I started.
These are always the best stories.
Yes, so this is a story of the serial shitter.
The serial shitter?
Yes.
Oh my god.
This already sounds interesting.
So, while I was working, the guy who was training me was telling me, you can find all sorts of fucked up shit in the bathrooms. And, he was telling me about, this serial shitter, where someone would go into women's bathroom and shit on the floor.
Oh.
And this happened multiple times.
Okay, I've got one way better for you.
Oh god.
So recently our company changed the policy, but it used to be that management and management only could clean up any human residue, such as blood, fecal matter, urine, etc., etc. They recently changed this, however, so now I have to do it. But before that happened, there was a someone in the women's restroom who literally just took a shit, on the seat. Like, you had to be an obese woman with a fucking camel ass to miss that much.
No. You think that's bad.
But...
Oh my god.
It was literally like a fucking cow pie on the back of the fucking toilet seat. I'm not even exaggerating. And so I just had to pick up the phone and dial for a manager. Whichever one that just picked up was lucky enough. And as it just so happened...
You should have just said when that person picked up... the person's like, hello? Congratulations!
Every time I was like, you're gonna hate me. And I swear to God, the one that just went in, I could have gotten the assistant manager of the store, and he would have completely blown it off, but the one that I did get, he just went in there and looked completely pissed off.
Yeah. I wanna fucking rage quit.
Oh my
Fuck
God.
This. I quit. Find somebody else. They tried pulling that shit out with me at Kmart. I was like, no. You guys don't pay me enough for this.
The only shit, honestly, the only shit that, even though they changed the policy, I don't care. The only shit that I clean up is the shit that you clean up with the wand inside the toilet. That's the only shit I clean up. Because that is completely fucking different from handling fecal matter in my hands.
Alright, I got one for you guys.
Okay.
Alright, so, obviously, you know, there's changing rooms in the, or not changing rooms, but like rooms.
Dressing rooms.
They can try it. Yeah, dressing rooms, thank you. that they can go in and try clothes on. Well, this lady decided she was going to go in there with her daughter, and her daughter really had to go to the bathroom, but the mother was just like, no, no, I'm not going to take her to the bathroom, nothing. So she instructed the daughter to just go right there.
Literally, what?
Like, you could... It's fucked up. Because there's no cameras obviously pointing into the
changing room,
dressing rooms. So it's like low enough to where they can see the floor. And all of a sudden, you just see the little girl kind of like lean up against the side of the room, and just you could see it drop onto the floor. Right onto the floor, and like, fucking, oh my god, one of the ladies that was there for the changing room. She went in and she she went and grabbed the manager instantly. The manager came back, like, found the lady in the store and made her clean it up. And then banned her from the store. I was like, this is the most amazing thing I've ever seen. And the most fucked up.
Holy shit. But, also, I found a uranium ore.
Get that. We need it for the nuclear reactor. Yeah.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Have you guys had experience cleaning the toilet?
Yes, I work with that district.
Okay. As you time cleaning the toilet, have you noticed that that the toilet gets clogged more in the women's room or the men's room?
Women's room, all the fucking room. Time. Yes. All the fucking time. Tampons, man. Not tampons. It's always some fucking bullshit. I hate going in that women's restroom because it's always awkward for me. Because, like, what if someone walks in? I always put the trash can in the door. But even still, children walk in there not knowing. And it's like, okay, what the fuck am I going to do? Yeah, so.
Edophile.
Fuck you.
Sorry. Keep going. He's not a pedophile, everyone. It's a joke.
God, it's just. It's always awkward whenever that happens.
Yeah, I find it strange that it's like more times the women's room is like clogged. And yet, you would expect that to happen more in the men's room.
And it's so weird
somehow, we're cleaner than they are.
It's really weird. And yet, they always complain to us. They always do the role reversal.
There was this one time, I was told to, like,
I need this.
Like, someone complained that the women's restroom smelled bad. And guess what? When I went into the room, it smelled completely fine. It smelled better than in the men's room.
Okay.
It's just, I don't understand. I just don't understand what their standards are.
I can't even begin to understand that.
Very, very high. I apologize. Totally just said that wrong.
I always wondered why women always complain about the gas station restrooms. And I always go in the gas station restrooms. They're perfectly fine. I'm always wondering why they're always complaining. It's got to be because the women's restroom is always disgusting. Because they make it so.
We had any female followers right now.
Yeah, they'd be gone. Yeah, so
I would kind of expect your wife to intervene.
No, she's upstairs.
She's upstairs. She can't hear me. Okay. Well, she might be able to hear me. I just don't think she cares.
She might confirm it.
This is a possibility. It might. She might.
Yeah. I wouldn't put it past her.
As an expert woman, she could probably confirm it.
As someone who's majored in the field.
Yes.
Alright, there we go.
You go.
I've
you go ahead.
I've confirmed that you can grow trees inside of the
other dimension?
Yeah, the other dimension.
All right.
I've grown trees in here.
You can grow trees anywhere.
Only problem, they're probably flammable.
Well, yeah, why wouldn't they be?
Well, it's in the Nether.
No, the dimensional door.
Okay.
The one that I put in your heaven over there.
Ah, yes.
Alright, so I'm going to give a quick recap for those of you who are listening now, because I mentioned this while it was off stream. But while I was pushing carts one day, I find some weird shit. And one of the days in the middle of June, I found skis. That's not actually. It's actually up there. It's up there on the list. I found some really fucked up shit just because some people are trying to get rid of their garbage. Some people threw out electric grills. Some people. Yep. I found a mailbox. I found a mailbox.
Yeah.
It's.
It's fucked up. Some people just don't care.
Yeah.
A man's treasure is another man's, or one man's garbage is another man's treasure.
Yeah.
This is true. And for some things, that's very true. But, like, so in New York State, I'm pretty sure you have to pay a certain amount of money to get rid of oil and things like that, like car oil.
Yes.
People, when I worked for Home Depot, people would drive up with their vehicles, unload all their oil into, like, into a shopping cart or something, inside of containers and stuff, and just leave it there and drive away. So we would have to shell out like $600 per container. So just, it's pretty ridiculous when some people leave to like, oh, I don't want to deal with this, so I'll leave it here and let them deal with it. Because it's not like we can just take it and throw it in the garbage.
It's horse crap, but at the same time, the people like that they have to put up with, it makes you appreciate the good customers even more.
Absolutely. I agree. Is that no, it doesn't make me appreciate it.
Well, there's some, like the lady that gave me that bought my drink.
Yeah, but then there's some that you're just like, what the fuck is your issue?
Why would you do this to me?
Okay, I actually have a very serious one that actually happened about 2 years ago.
Uh-oh.
Oh, no.
So,
am I going to cry?
No. There's heartbreak, but
I bet I'm going to laugh really hard.
I wouldn't... You're absolutely going to laugh. So, there was one time where... one of the other areas that I have to maintenance for is the bottle center. And I do a pretty good job at... It's fine. I hate... It's okay. It's okay. It's quiet sometimes, so it's a nice place to escape. Anyway. So, one time, there was this woman who walked in there, and the floor was completely clean. Maybe it was a little sticky, because soda gets poured on, and when soda dries, it gets sticky. But she walked in there, literally... I'm not even exaggerating. I'm being completely serious with this. She walked in there with oil drums filled with cans. And she, because of that, there was literally liquid pouring out of it. And she slipped on that. And she tried to accuse me of not cleaning the floor properly. And this was 2 days before I was going to leave for college.
Wow.
Oh, wow. That shit would have pissed me off.
Bad. Do you think, like, it's lady, set up?
Absolutely. It's gotta be. Sometimes
it is. Like, I've seen some stuff where people have, like, legitimately, like, gone in and, like, tried to set the store up. And, like, try to get money out of it. And it's like, dude, you're not gonna get away with this. There's cameras everywhere, first of all. And even when there's not, there's a reason why people have jobs. They have jobs to come in and do this work. Not to fucking stand around and do nothing.
Well, some people do get paid to do that, but...
Yeah.
They're just...
But you know what I mean? Like, you know, the reason why people are here is to prevent this. This is why you have a cleaning crew. This is why you have associates that go around the stores and clean and tidy up things.
Yes.
Yes, a lot. There's quite a few that don't do that. I'm not going to sit there and say that, you know, that doesn't happen. It fucking happens.
It happens way too much.
There are lazy-ass people that work in that industry and makes everyone else look really bad.
I mean, it's like the customer is not going to do it. And someone has to do it, and they're going to feel miserable if you just, like, fuck over their day. Now, it'd be time to your janitor or whoever cleans or who just has to deal with your bullshit. Kind to them. Nice.
Except don't be kind to the ones that are actually douchebags. Don't be kind to those ones.
For wonderful people's sake, you know, the people that actually do their jobs and do them well. And there are quite a few of them out there that don't get the recognition for it. Those are the people you should be kind to.
Yes.
They make sure that your supermarket and wherever you work is clean and tidy and good for you to be able to shop and with your family. Be nice to them.
Yes.
They're probably going through college, they're probably having some money issues, and they just don't want to deal with all this bullshit.
No one wants to put up with you fucking being a complete bitch for no reason while your children over there screaming their heads off, trying to escape your leash. Literally trying to escape your child leash. I always feel like that those children...
Explain to me what the hell the child leash is for. This is just...
Wait, is there really a child leash? I thought that
there are children leashes. I've seen them so many times.
It's a harness that goes around them. Like, you know the harnesses that go around the animal's arms and legs and, like, wraps around the body?
Yeah.
That's what they have for kids. And it has a legitimate leash on it.
It's so fucking dumb.
What the fuck is this?
Okay, if you don't believe that they exist, just go spend at least 2 hours in McDonald's.
Walmart
or McDonald's. Either one, really.
I guess I'm lucky enough not to see this. Holy shit.
It happens so much.
Crazy.
Is your kid, a fucking dog?
Apparently.
I remember my mother was, like, watching some sort of reality TV show, and they would, like, set up these fake scenarios around real people, and it's, like, this, person, put her kid in that type of dog leash thing, and she kind of just, like, tied it to a fire hydrant and just went into a store, leaving it out. She went to a stranger and was like, hey, can you hold this? And watch him. Yeah. It's just weird.
These are also the kind of people that would make the people angry as hell inside because they're going in there to bitch.
Right.
About something.
Which one do you guys think is worse? The children on leashes, or people that leave dogs inside cars for a long time?
Dogs, the dogs. That makes me
because
worry.
Because dogs could potentially die.
That's a good point.
Well, I mean, okay, technically, you know, it's just as bad as leaving. You know what? Personally, I think it's about evil. You know?
Yeah, it's one of those on margin.
It's just like leaving a kid in a car with the windows cracked.
Shit
is fucked up.
It's really fucked up.
I hate people sometimes.
Alright, I made some more furnaces. In case we didn't have enough. Alright, how do I make a generator?
Alright, there is a limit to the as the length you can go out in the dimensional door.
Hmm, really not.
You can, yeah, I found it. It is 1, 2, 3, 4
batteries.
Squares out from the sides. That is how far you can go.
Shit. Oh no, I don't. Oh, fuck, I need more copper cable, don't I? I like that cheerful chime that you get whenever you hit a new level.
Yeah.
This isn't Zelda.
I could dream, you know.
Da na na na.
I'm not even gonna attempt to do the Zelda sound, whatever it is.
I got a stick.
Da na na na.
I will admit,
one
though,
of those times that I wish I had like a mixer to be able to do sounds with.
I will admit, though, that Nintendo is kind of really linear with their games. They're really all kind of similar. The Mario games are similar, and the Zelda games can be similar at times.
Yeah, but I mean, like, that's what people want, though. Like,
sometimes.
I mean, it's making the money.
It is,
yeah,
but
they have been making games longer than any other company.
Very
other
true.
Than Atari.
But, I mean, if you look at it, Atari still had, like, a good-sized break on making games. Like, I mean, like, consoles and everything. Atari stopped making consoles a long time ago.
Very true.
So, I mean, like, Nintendo has literally been one of the companies that has been making games and consoles for the longest. Would I say that they're the best? I could say they're up there. But at least they have stuck with it and, you know, have not tried to go to new things.
I mean, at least it's not Call of Duty.
Very true. Well, no, they've done Call of Duty on, they've done Call of Duty
yeah,
on the Wii U.
Just Call of Duty, they also had Call of Duty on,
I mean, like, at
Game
least
Boy.
They're not doing, like, Call of Duty. What Call of Duty's doing.
Oh,
the same thing.
Oh, yeah, well, like, where they're always trying to improvise and make things better, even though it
yeah,
really shouldn't
just
be
the same
it.
Thing. Oh, do you know what I heard, like, a few, like, yesterday?
What'd you hear?
What?
There's some sort of petition going on.
Oh, joy.
For a remastered version of Modern Warfare 2.
That's fucking dumb.
What?
Yeah, and
if they,
I
they
literally
remaster any of them, it should be Modern Warfare 4 or whatever it is.
No,
that's what a lot of people are saying. And I made the tweet, it was that quote and said, I thought they were already doing that every year.
Honestly, if they're gonna remake any game, they should just compile all the Nazi zombies into one game.
Yeah, do that. Nazi zombies is like the only fun game type I like about Call of Duty games.
I mean, I bought the new one. I actually really liked it. I thought, you know, it's fun.
Yeah, I heard it's like different to the others, but it's just,
it's still similar in ways, but I mean, like, it's something new. You know, they tried doing it with Ghost, but Ghost was, you know, wasn't really up to par yet. Where with Advanced Warfare, you know, they brought in a decent crew to do the storyline with it. You know, they had Kevin Spacey as the bad guy.
Yeah, Kevin Spacey.
I don't know if you're joking or not. I think he's actually pretty cool.
He is really good. I like him in House of Cards.
All right. I wasn't sure if you were, you know, you're joking or if, you know, you're being serious. Honestly,
I love kids. Kevin Spacey.
Awesome.
He's a really good actor.
He's okay in my book. I mean, I've kind of looked back at some of the older films that I used to like. No. Like, just some of the older films I look at, and it's more physical comedy than anything else. I'm not against it. It's just not in my taste anymore. I've kind of grown out of it.
Watch him in House of Cards.
I'm waiting. Once it's done, I will be sitting down and watching the entire thing from start to finish.
Do you really only watch series after they're done?
No, I am actually watching several series right now that are coming out. But most of the stuff that I tend to watch is anime. I watch that as it comes out. TV series, I really try to wait, especially if it's something that I'm going to be extremely into, because while I'm at work, I watch TV a lot, so I try to save up as much and, like, do huge chunks of TV watching while I'm at work, because I've got 8 hours to do rounds, and, you know, as I'm doing them, I need something to do while I'm sitting at the desk, so I watch TV.
Right.
You know. What better way to do it than watch TV?
Good point.
I mean, if you really want to see a good Kevin Spacey performance, watch House of Cards. He does a great job as Frank Underwood.
I actually started watching House of Cards. That's why I was like, yeah, I really like this, but I don't want to watch it yet.
I didn't think the third season was, like, all of that good, but I still enjoyed it. He's still really good in that one.
Mm-hmm. Well, Andrew, you got something to try and watch him in.
I'll give it a shot. I mean,
I suggested this, like, the last podcast we did.
Yeah, I know you did.
Wait, do you do podcasts when it comes to, like, TV shows and stuff?
Just general topics.
It's typically just banter.
Please, for the love of God, invite me the next time you do it, because I will totally get in on this conversation.
We're doing one tomorrow.
The thing is that I kind of just don't, like, I kind of want you to get new headphones, because I kind of just don't want to upload with the audio like this.
Okay. Understandable.
Yeah.
I'll see what I can do. I do not want to make any promises on headphones, just because right now I'm, as I think I said the last time, I'm saving up to move. So we'll see what's going on.
Oh, whoops.
Because that's going to be a pretty big purchase when I go to buy a new headset.
Right.
I mean, that's fun to really way that your mic can't detect us.
I can try the other headset that Eric was using, but that one sounded like it was really quiet, but we might be able to do something sound-wise with that. If I need to, I might be able to borrow Eric's headset. What time would you guys be doing the podcast tomorrow?
Any time. Really, it doesn't matter.
Typically before 8 or 9.
Typically,
PM?
Yeah, PM.
Oh,
yeah.
Right.
Yeah, because we do the thing every week as well.
The shindig.
The shindig?
What we did last week. Streaming this, basically.
Oh, yeah, we every week we pick a game to
just
to
play.
Stream.
Yeah.
Alright. That's cool.
Okay.
No,
what do I
really
need?
I Redstone. Like movies. You know, I like talking about them. So, you know, if you guys do something like that, I'm more than willing to get on it.
Hmm. Yeah, I would like to get some more people on there. Try to get more banter, because sometimes we just kind of come quiet and try to think what to talk about next.
Talk about next.
Which is exactly how we came up with the whole fucking looking up. What's his face? Ringo Starr's art?
No. We were looking up, like, we were thinking of a word.
Oh yeah, we literally had one time where it was he came up. I said one word and he said the other, and we searched what came up.
Oh Jesus!
And we just read out loud what the reaction was to us.
We looked up dingus, Canadian, and Welsh cabbages.
Welsh cabbages.
Yeah.
Who came up with Welsh cabbage? Like,
I said Welsh, and he said cabbage.
With Welsh, I came up with cabbages.
Yeah.
That's pretty funny.
It's kind of like its own little ad lib, and seeing what the result is.
Yeah. It mostly ends up with us just trying to describe this image we're looking at.
We've only done that twice, though.
Yeah, we did that with Ringo Starr.
Well, we're gonna put this right here on the refrigerator. Oh, I love Family Guy.
Family Guy or South Park? Which one would you watch more?
South Park.
You know, if I truly had to pick, neither, because I'd rather watch American Dad.
Yeah, American Dad's pretty good. I don't get what. Have you heard, like, the people's criticism is that it tries too much to be, like, Family Guy.
Even it was around beforehand.
It was created by the guy who made Family Guy.
Yeah, I understand what you're saying, but, like, people are fucking stupid.
You know what? Seth MacFarlane has it going. Seth MacFarlane has it going.
Yes, he does.
He's got two movies.
So well.
One of them.
Yeah, he has Ted 2 coming out.
Yeah.
He had Liam Neeson.
He somehow got Liam Neeson in fucking A Thousand Ways to Die in the West.
Oh yeah. And got him to show his ass. By the way.
Oh my God.
That was his ass.
Yeah, that was his ass. That he and they stuck a daisy in it.
I heard that movie was terrible, but now I want to see
it.
It
was the replay
value. Is not all that good. It's like once you watch it, watch it once, at least once. Go rent it, whatever. Rent it once.
I could give you a link to.
Reviews is basically just all the skits from just Family Guy.
No.
Not really. Like it was better.
Okay, we're gonna go fix that.
It's really hard to explain. Not hard to explain, but like, I didn't get the feeling that it was just we're rehashing all our jokes.
It's not rehashing. Like, I mean, it's like watching a compilation, a montage of just the skits of Family Guy.
Okay.
I feel like there was a few of them that you know they obviously took from Family Guy and. The hell's that the cavalcade of cartoons that he did?
Oh, that like yeah, I know what you're talking about.
It was all shorts and shit like that.
Yeah.
I feel like he took a couple from that, like the sheep that was like, shear my ass.
Wes, what I can do so you can get to watch the movie at some point, I can give you a link to my Flixer, which has it documented on there. So you can just stream it.
Flixster.
Well, for my birthday, I got A Million Ways to Die in the West, which is why I just recently watched it.
Okay.
And with that, it came with Ultraviolet, which I don't understand how it works, but with that, it connects.
Isn't Ultraviolet like, it's like Blu-ray to DVD?
No. It's a digital version.
Yeah.
They just call it Ultraviolet. It's a Sony thing.
I can literally look up what I have on my Flixer library right now.
I have a couple hundred movies on there because every time I buy a movie, I get a thing for that.
All right, let's see what I have right now in my collection. Million Ways to Die in the West, Anchorman, Amazing Spider-Man, The Hobbit, Man of Steel, To Kill a Mockingbird, Back to the Future, the Harry Potter series, V for Vendetta.
I just remember what I was going to do today, and I I'm mad I didn't do it. For the podcast, I wanted to talk about Hansel and Gretel, this like horror movie on Netflix, and there was sequel on there, and they looked terrible, and I kind of just want to talk about it on the podcast, but I didn't get a chance to watch it.
Mm. It's never too late.
It's always tomorrow.
Yeah, if there's time.
No, it's a Disney song. There's always tomorrow.
Oh.
Never mind. I'm a geek. Don't judge me.
We will judge you if we want to.
There's a creeper right in front of me. Great. Oh shit, there's another one. Oh my god, I just got bombarded by two creepers and I'm almost dead.
You know, it's scary to think that this is what I'm doing at 3 a.m.
Is it real?
It's almost 3 a.m. Yeah.
Holy shit. I mean, it's not a big deal. Like,
I don't mind it. It's definitely better than just laying down and fucking being a corpse for 8 hours.
If you guys weren't gonna be on, I was gonna play Grand Theft Auto. That's what I was gonna do.
Mm.
Which is still a possibility. You guys may still get off and, I don't know, do something else.
I doubt it.
I'm gonna get my water out.
It's better than practicing being dead.
For 8 hours.
Lay in this bed and practice.
We can sleep when we're dead, okay?
Alright. Going here. I'll be right back. I'm gonna go grab something to drink now that Andrew reminded me.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm gonna get you too. Andrew, keep people company.
How do you expect me to do that?
Talk to yourself.
Sing and dance.
I can't dance. People can't see. People wouldn't be able to see me dance.
Well, I think we'd have to like all go and see him so that they're all seeing him dance.
Yeah, that'd be a pain in the ass, and I'd have to have it in a first person looking at me perspective. No, a third person looking at me perspective.
What?
Which is kind of weird that you can do that. Like, you can actually, like, what is it, Z to do that? I can't remember.
No, I think it's F5. It's F5.
You're talking about real life.
No. Third person look at myself perspective. I can't.
That's the one thing I never
roll my eyeballs.
Let's get a GoPro turned around.
Yeah.
All right, you guys go get your drink.
Yeah, I'll be right back.
I'll be right back.
So, everybody listening, I have a cat. It's outside of my house. People have been trying to kill it since I got it, and I don't understand why. I also almost fell to my death. That happened. Yeah. I should probably get back to looking for redstone at some point, but fuck that. I want to fly around like majestic. Wait. Everyone in my stream is going to be able to see this better. I'm going to... Whee! Flying around at the speed of sound. Ground's getting close! Oh, God. Oh god, okay. This is another portal. And it's got dirt in the corners, which I'm now gonna take out. I think we should build a house around this fucking thing. I don't know why we have it in the first place. Fuck! Gravity! No! Okay. So, there's a reason why I have a jetpack. That's reason number one. Ooh. Okay. I have a sword. It's called Sebastian the Strong. Namely named because I am Hoopla and Sebastian. And the two weapon classes fall under Hoopla the Great and Sebastian the Strong. So, yes, there's that. Fuck! There's zombies everywhere. And creepers. There's so many mobs. Okay. I just gave them dialogue.
Who would have thunk that Sprite would be good, like, I don't know, like, 15 hours later, being in the fridge with no lid on it?
I honestly did not expect that at all.
Yeah, it's like in a paper Subway cup.
Oh, hi, Enderman! You know what? You're so eager to get me, aren't you? Yeah, it's a good thing I'm flying right now. Wow, that was actually kind of entertaining. I just watch Enderman jump to their death. Because I can fly.
Nice. I didn't think Endermen could kill themselves like that.
Yep, I just saw one do it. I was going to drag them to the ocean, but he decided to go and commit suicide instead.
Well, either way it works.
Yep, job gets done, that's all that matters. Alright, what the fuck am I doing? Oh, I need redstone, that's what I've been trying to do.
Oh, I've got redstone, I found another 48 redstone in my chest.
Alright. What I'm trying
is that
to do.
What loud noise was?
What was it?
I don't know, it sounded like you were, like, opening a door or something.
Well, it must have been my door I opened and closed.
Alright.
It's very loud.
So, what I want to do right now is I'm going to try and build at least one low voltage solar power. So, solar panel. So we can use that to fuel an MFE, which will then be used to fuel a teleporter. If we do that, though, we're going to need a lot of time in between our usage of them. But nonetheless, I do want to try and build a teleporter to the other village.
How often can you use the teleporter?
Because being a low voltage solar power, I wouldn't be able to tell you. It'd probably be anywhere from 10 to 15 minutes! There are mobs inside of your house. There are mobs inside of your house.
Inside my house?
Yes, your fucking big house.
My big house? What?
Yeah, the one with the oil fountain.
That's the building.
The building. Okay, fine then. There are mobs in the building.
The building.
No, anytime I'm talking about where my chests are, I'm talking about inside the dimensional door.
Okay, well, I was just trying to explore and rant. Oh, hi! Hi! Hello! Okay. I'm coming to you. Oh, fuck you, Skeleton. I'm coming to you now.
Do we have any more stories to talk about?
I think I'm going to get up for a second and get some painkiller, because my neck's starting to hurt a bit. Alright, I'm inside the dimensional door, but I'm going to get a painkiller.
Trying to think. I know I've got some good stuff.
Alright, people on my Twitch, I'll be right back. So, there you go. Okay, I'm back.
I'm playing Pokemon Shuffle.
Apparently he's playing Pokemon Shuffle.
Oh, is that that little, I just downloaded that. The game's awesome. I don't like that you can't, like, consistently play. But
I know.
It's still pretty cool.
I fucking hate games who, like, kind of try to cash in. Like, oh, you want to play more? Well, how about you give me some money?
But, I mean, like, I guess, like, I you know, I can deal with, you know, instead of being, like, some of the Facebook games where you've got to wait, like, fucking
hours?
15 hours.
Hmm.
At least with this, it's, you know,
it's like every 25 minutes you get a turn. Yeah.
Yeah.
Reasonable.
Which I should have, like, a full thing now.
Alright, I got the 48 redstone.
Alright, take it. If you come down here, I think I have some in here as well. In my little mine shaft that I've been working on.
Alright, honestly, I'm gonna go and explore hell so I can get some more redstone. Because redstone's the thing then.
Before you go, let me, hold on. I've only got 4 pieces here, so you can either come down and grab them or go do what you're doing.
No, I think I'd be better off going into hell.
You're good.
So, I've been experimenting with this diet that I've been doing recently, and apparently, one of the main things that the dealio is with this, it's mainly called a fast, but I'm considering it some sort of diet. And
technically fasting is bad for you, but
yeah.
Continue.
So, I'm only allowed to eat 1 meal a day, and I'm allowed to eat healthy snacks in between. Even though, I've still been cheating on it entirely. That still doesn't matter. I've still been losing weight at a pretty good rate.
So what have you been doing exactly? Like, what is your exact routine throughout the whole day?
Well, I'm either, for snacks, I'm eating nothing but fruit. And at the end of the day, I have a chicken salad.
Okay, so you're, what are you doing for protein other than that?
That's a good question. For grains, I know for grains, I'm doing oatmeal for breakfast.
Okay, but I mean, like, specific, like, proteins, like, are you eating nuts and things like that that would give you protein, or are you taking vitamins
not considered that yet.
I'm trying to think of the word that I would die, no.
But I could easily squeeze in some nuts during the diet. Well.
But make sure, like, if you do nuts, make sure they're unsalted.
Yes, absolutely. Salted nuts,
like,
are not healthy,
like,
for you.
Like, it's not that they're not healthy, it's just there's a shit ton of, there's a lot more sodium in them. But, like, you don't want to eat, like, 5 tons of them.
Right.
Or sunflower seeds are another good one.
You know, well, after I got acid reflux, I thought, like, the only diet I was doing was, like, eat less, eat some yogurt if I feel hungry, and just don't try to cave into food. And it's like, eat 1 meal a day. That sounds, unhealthy.
Completely uncomfortable.
It can be,
but I
will,
like,
admit.
If you're snacking, like, if you're...
I do, I
you know,
eat
if like
an...
If you're eating, like, go ahead.
I eat like an apple or oranges in replace for what would normally be consistent of meals for me.
Yeah.
So I am still getting... I am still getting somewhat of a appetite filled, but it is considerably unhealthy even still. But I don't want to go all anorexia trying to lose weight. That's just fucking insane.
Well, it's bad for you, and your body will actually retain anything that you put in. It'll be like, oh, you know, I don't know when I'm going to get my next meal, so I'm going to try and keep all of it in and not burn any of it off.
Right. Instead of losing weight, I'd end up gaining in the process.
Exactly. Like, I've had that issue, too, where, like, you know, I try to do the whole fasting where I don't eat a lot. You know, I eat very little.
Right.
But if you do that for a long period of time, you end up gaining a lot of weight, too.
Yeah, I don't plan on doing it for too terribly long.
But, I mean, you're still eating other things. You're not,
yes.
You're not just eating. You're not eating. You know what I mean?
Yeah. I'm still eating and having my appetite quenched. I'm even cheating on the diet and I'm still losing weight. So that's got us something.
I want to attempt to like get a gym membership and get in somewhere.
Yeah,
but it's so expensive.
It is. My family just recently got a membership to the YMCA. I just haven't had the opportunity to go.
I have a membership, but I just haven't gone because, like, every time someone's able to drive me, it's not a convenient time because I'm probably doing something.
Right. Most of the time, it's actually the stream itself that I end up doing, but I don't want to put off the stream too much and then end up completely forgetting it. So.
I mean, it's not only a stream, it's like, I came back from work from the morning, and it's just, all I want to do is sleep.
I know that feeling. Especially since my shift is, like, from midnight to 8 in the morning, Monday through Friday.
Yeah, your shift has sex.
My shift sucks balls.
Aren't some gyms open 24/7?
Yes, but, like, the only one that I know of that is Planet Fitness, and they're ridiculous when it comes to trying to get a gym membership, because they literally want to know your social security numbers, your account information, because they want to, like, even if you're not paying them, they want to try and pull money out of your accounts. Like, I know a couple of people that have actually gone negative because Planet Fitness has tried pulling money after they had told them, we can't pay this, you know, and, like, they continued to try and pull money out. They like, pretty much had to go to their bank and went, if this even, like, shows up, it is to be denied. They're like, assholes when it comes to their money.
Yeah, I was considering going to Planet Fitness at some point, but even still, even though they say it's a judgment-free zone, it still sounds like that they're going to be surrounded by douchebags there.
Yeah, I would not doubt it.
So,
God, we got into a random topic.
Yeah, you're welcome.
I wanted to go into talking about Max some more, because we were talking about that and it kind of just stops.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Fucking...
Yeah. Andrew, so...
You're welcome.
Max stories, Andrew?
Not off the top of my head that I can think of.
Not really?
No, not really.
Like, God, talk about that...
You know... Okay, I got one. I got a Max story for you. I'm gonna do this while turning around and opening up a thing of chocolate bar, because that's my cheat of the day.
Whoa, that's not good, man. Peter.
Dude, I fucking ate a bag of chips the other day, and I woke up and I still lost like 2 pounds.
Wish I was losing 2 pounds. It was fucking awesome.
But, okay. So one day I was playing Quantum of Solace. I'm pretty sure I've told this story to you, Quinn, at least once. I'm guarantee I've told this to you before. But there was one time where I was playing Quantum of Solace, I was playing multiplayer, and I received this random picture message from Max on the Xbox, and he's like, dude, I finally got my recon armor! I'm like, okay, well, might as well check it out, see what this is. Yeah, okay. Yep. And I opened it up in the middle of my match, and I'm like, okay, what's so important about recon armor? And it's his fucking dick. It's a picture of his dick.
Oh, damn.
He sent that to Chaz, too.
Oh, my.
That's horrible. would be absolutely hilarious at the same time. And I would be pissed if this happened to me. Wow!
I had one, but I forgot.
Yeah, that one kind of takes the cake.
Holy shit.
So, yeah, hey, Rob, you want to meet Max?
No, I actually talked to Max, like, a few months ago. Hasn't really changed too much, but he's still playing World of Warcraft. Yes. That calmed him down a bit. Mm.
Really? World of Warcraft?
He was very strong in World of Warcraft when it came to playing
that
game.
Yeah, like, we introduced him, and, like, me and Chaz introduced him, and, like, we weren't really too big to it. I mean, Chaz is a little bit, but, like, I'm not really big into MMOs because it's too time-consuming, and I just...
I absolutely agree.
Yeah, and I like to go into other things, and... Like, we introduced this to him, and we did not know he would get addicted to it. Like, I'm pretty sure he couldn't... Either he just decided to stop playing, or he couldn't pay for a month. And, like,
yeah, but see, this
cried.
Is why there's free accounts.
Huh?
There's free accounts now.
Yeah,
but he could only go up to level 20.
Is that what it is? I couldn't remember.
I tried World of Warcraft on one of the free trials, and honestly, I didn't like it.
It's not too bad. It's just time-consuming. I want to get into other stuff, like I said.
Absolutely.
When I played, I got really, really bad into it, to the point where, like, I was selling gold and everything, and it got pretty bad. Like, I got a ban for, like, 6 months, because I got caught selling gold, obviously. But,
What's so wrong with selling gold?
Because they do not offer a way to buy gold outside of the game. They do not want people selling it in game.
Have you heard of this new system they were coming up with?
Gold system or what?
It's kind of, it's a subscription system, but basically. It's called WoW tokens, and basically what you can do is that if you could buy a WoW token and sell it on the auction house and buy it from there.
Oh.
Yeah.
Like, could you use them to like pay for your subscription?
Yeah.
Oh, you know what? This is like what the hell was it? There's a game they play over in Japan where as you get like, you know, a certain amount of gold in the game, you can actually take it and buy actual game time. Like, it's a ridiculous amount of money, but, you know.
Yeah, it's very similar to the game EVE Online.
Yes, EVE Online is one of them, but it's ridiculous the amount. I played for a little bit, and wasn't a big fan of it just because of how it played, but, you know.
Yeah, like I said, I'm not a big fan of the MMO genre. I would like to play them, but it's just too time-consuming.
I prefer to get
into other stuff.
Honestly, I agree with that, because that's the main reason why I don't play Diablo. It's really time-consuming. It's not even an MMO, but I still find it time-consuming.
Diablo's actually, like, it seems like it's time-consuming, but it's really not. Like, you could get on one day and be like, oh, I'm gonna go play for, like, 3 hours and not play for like 6 months and jump back on and be like, oh, I'm gonna play for 3 hours. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, it's really not, like, it sounds like it is, but it's really not. Like, they've really, I have to say, Diablo has come to a point where it's like, oh, this is actually semi enjoyable.
Oh.
Like, I play,
Hello.
Go ahead.
No, I was gonna say, you and me have played the game before together, but
yeah,
in Diablo 3, but I've never actually technically beaten the story. I've never played through Act 1 through Act 5. I've never done it.
It's one of those you don't need to.
I played through the story, and I honestly thought it was kind of mediocre.
I do have to say, the number three was Diablo 3 was story wise was kind of shitty.
Yeah.
1 and 2 had a better story. And 2 was like, I can't remember if there was a single player campaign. I think you ended up playing online most of the time. It's been so long since I played Diablo 2.
Honestly, Diablo 3 was the first one I played, so I wouldn't know.
I have Diablo, but I haven't really played it that much.
Right, how's my jetpack?
I've been playing since I was like a little kid, so it was one of those, you know, my brothers had it, so I played it, you know.
What other game is there that, that they've made? I can't remember the company name, but...
The Blizzard? World of Warcraft? StarCraft? I mean...
They've only made, like... Haven't they only made, like...
What other game did they make?
Okay, I have to ask. Haven't they only made, like, 5 series?
No, there's been a few others.
There's
like,
Hearthstone, there's World of Warcraft, Diablo.
There's the Heroes of... I can't remember.
Heroes of the Storm.
Yeah, that.
I feel like that there's one other one. Hearthstone is the one that's card-based, that's free. StarCraft, that was the other one.
They made some other ones for, like, the SNES era games.
Well, yeah, but...
Yeah.
That's like saying that everyone's going to recognize anything off of here. Anything from that area. Crap, I can't even go in the dimensional door.
What does that mean, Andrew?
One thing I've realized about the dimensional door, by the way, guys, if there are monsters on the other side of the wall, they can still attack you, even though you're on the dimensional door. Like, you are literally walking past the wall, and they can still attack you, even though you're in the other dimension.
Andrew, you were saying something about the SNES games. Like, it's like being recognized for something, whatever you said. What does that even mean?
I don't know.
What are you saying?
I don't know. Okay? I just don't know. I don't think I got a single piece of redstone from that trip. I got gold, I got diamond, but I didn't get fucking redstone. Can I make redstone?
No.
Let's see.
Well, if there's a way to make it.
Let's see.
Hey, Wes, how far have you played in this Pokemon Shuffle game?
That's right. Nether Redstone.
I would like to say, like, an hour, maybe two.
But I mean, like, level-wise. Like, how many levels are you in?
I guess I'm going to the Nether.
26.
Alright, I'm gonna mute my mic and eat really quick. I don't want to chew into the microphone, so I'm gonna mute it.
Why not? I want to listen to you chew. No comment. Jesus Christ.
Well, he said he's gonna mute it.
Oh, I didn't.
There's his comment.
Weirdo. I was looking down at the Game Boy.
Yeah.
Let's shut this up, because I'll still play this for...
I mean, like I said, like, the microtransactions, I hate it when people do the whole, like, oh, want to play more? Give us some money, and it's kind of just very sleazy.
But at least it's
not as bad, because I could actually wait 25 minutes.
Yeah, like, you can find something to do for 25 minutes, go back, do your next, you know...
I'm back.
My biggest problem, I did Facebook games for a while, and it got bad because it was like, are you serious? Like, one, you know, I ended up doing like one move and I'd be done for like the entire day. It's like, come on.
Yeah.
I just paid you guys this money to be able to play.
I'm not waiting 3 hours just for a building to build. I'm not.
Yeah. Or, no, that wasn't even the worst part. Like, there were some, like, I was playing, one of the war ones, I can't remember what it was, but it took like a month to build something, and I was like, this is ridiculous, I'm done playing this, I'm done.
Oh my god, I gotta tell you this, like, very shitty iPhone app experience I had. I forgot what the game was called, but it was like something arcane, and basically it's like this war game where you build your kingdom and fight against other people. When you do the tutorial...
I've played this. I know what you're talking about.
When you play the tutorial, basically you're immune from other people invading you. But,
yeah.
So, like, what happened to me was, like, I got all the stuff. I got my established... I got the whole thing established. And when I, the lock to online was unlocked, I kept being repeatedly invaded.
Yeah.
And I couldn't do anything about it. So, it's basically give us money so you could actually protect yourself, or just too bad.
Yep. Sounds kind of dumb.
Yeah.
It's extremely
game
shitty.
Was shitty. What was that game? There were some Facebook games that are like that, that are just like, are you fucking kidding me? Like, I did the Simpsons game for a while.
Oh, tapping out.
That gets fucking bad.
Yeah, it does. I played that game.
Like, you get pretty fucking addicted to it, and it's you want to do this? Well, here, you can buy this, and they would advertise it every, like, 5 minutes. Like, oh, buy this. Like, no.
Yeah, that's the thing, you're probably getting enough money from advertisements.
Yes, I'm breaking too,
yeah.
Thank you. Let's also do...
Entire rant alone, just on free to play games that you have to pay to do things in.
Yeah, I've also been kind of getting out of the Family Guy one. That's kind of like the Simpsons one. It's the same exact fucking thing.
Family Guy one?
Yep, Family Guy, the quest for stuff.
Oh my god, that's horrible.
It's even better. Because there are literally special events where you can get certain characters, like the New Year's Eve one, you got Jillian. Like, where is the correlation in that?
I don't have a problem with free-to-play games, like games where you, like, throw money if you want this character or armor or something. But this is just too far...
Yeah.
Yes.
And as it is, I've been kind of doing the whole put it down and wait out the time, but then after a while, the time becomes more and more spaced out for me just because I'm less interested in it.
And I typically play these iPhone games to like pass the time, and it doesn't even do that well.
Yep.
God, I can just hear them getting angry.
When your game fails to kill time, there's a serious problem with your game.
Absolutely agree.
I just wish the mobile market isn't what it was. That's all that I wish it was. I wish it would be something different.
You know, sometimes I'm glad. What was that company? It was this really shitty company that made like they copied other games and made it iPhone apps. So that's with the Z. I forgot what they called.
Zumba.
No. They had a lawsuit with EA because they took EA's game.
That's a
Wasn't
good
that
company.
A golf game or something like that.
I don't remember.
I think I know what you're talking about. It was like they ended up taking a golf game. It was like a Tiger Woods game, and EA has like explicit
I think it was a Sims game. They copied their Facebook Sims game.
Okay. Yes. All right. I know what you're talking about now. Sorry.
God, it's so random.
Their name escapes me, but what are they called? Something. Yay.
I wouldn't even begin to tell you.
Hold on, I gotta Google this.
Google.
Google.
Oh, I thought I heard a creeper. Then I forgot it was something. Ah! Nope! There was definitely something exploding.
Okay.
Man, you gotta mine that shit fast. I got 9 out so far. Shit. Let's
see. Yay. Fun. Yay, blah. Then. Zynga. That's
Ginga?
The name.
Zynga.
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 Z-I-N-G-A.
Zynga.
Oh, Zynga. Got it. Ah, my catch.
Those guys were fucking assholes. And you know, I heard stories about, like, when the news broke in that their company just like is no longer exists. It like the employees just like went out and party and took like Zynga t-shirts and burnt them as if they were
trying. Shitty company to work for.
It was. It's.
I mean, like, all they did
was steal other shitty. Shitty Facebook games.
Honestly,
terrible.
Working for Zynga was probably the equivalent of working for a name store brand cola. Like, you're just ripping off the other ones, and it's just like, okay, well, what the fuck are we doing? Alright, where am I?
Making money.
Making money by ripping off other companies that just don't care.
Hey, but if the CEO gets out and runs away, what are you gonna do?
Very true.
You know, my money left. Like,
oh god. My pickaxe goes through fucking nether brick like it's fucking nothing.
Yeah, we're not gonna talk about my pickaxe. I lost it.
Oh. Oh, yeah, I'm sorry.
This
that
is
was
good.
What happened? Oh, God! I stopped to look at my inventory and I started falling. Oh, God. Sorry, go ahead.
What the fuck?
What just happened?
Okay, I guess it's done. But,
are you guys angry?
You're
not angry.
Do something, and, it's not done. I just had to shit out all the stuff. And directly below it, that it was digging is lava. Will that do anything?
No, it's actually fine.
But if it starts spitting stuff out, the lava will burn it.
Oh yeah, that's no.
But
it doesn't spit things out. It goes back and then it drops it.
Sorry.
You're thinking about the quarry.
Oh yeah.
The mining turtle's different. Nope. Go fuck yourself. Come here. Come here, Baka. Ha! Oh, I missed. Okay. I can't do a midair battle.
Any more stories you got?
I am battling a ghast. That's my story.
Please tell us more.
I can't because it's getting further away. Come back here, little shit! You wanna fight? Fight me!
I just imagine this on a story.
You're like a YouTube commenter, god damn it! Come over here and fight me! Okay, fine then, go fuck yourself. I'm walking away from this. Alright, how am I doing? I should be fine for a little bit more.
I'm bored, tell me stories.
Fucking
Andrew, tell us a bedtime story.
Okay, so one time the mama bear killed the papa bear because he ate
sucks.
The children. Well, fuck you too. You didn't even hear the story. You didn't even hear the plot twist. The mama bear was sleeping with the octopus.
Whoa.
Yeah, that was a fucking plot twist, wasn't it, bitch?
Yeah.
Yeah, you should have listened to it. It would have made sense. But no, you had to go and fucking interrupt it. Like a goddamn motherfucker.
Why would everyone want to listen to your story?
You asked for it!
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did. Your exact words were, I'm bored. Tell me a story. Oh, shit, I used the wrong pickaxe. I just made a new pickaxe and it's got an... Oh, no, it's fine. It's fine. It's got Unbreaking 2 on it and I don't really want to waste it yet. But it doesn't look like it took any health out.
Because it did not.
Because it's got Unbreaking 2.
I need a fucking thingamajig.
Where's my portal back?
Thingamajig.
Aha! What am I doing?
Cut me down a tree.
Okay. That's,
are you, George Washington now?
Oh, okay, you're angry. I can clearly understand that. Your demographics are completely different than from mine.
That thing is so wrong.
What?
Sorry, nothing. Don't mind me.
I've been trying not to, but you're still here.
Ouch.
I'm kidding.
Andrew, that hurt.
I love you, Rob.
I'm sad now.
I love you, Rob.
I'm gonna cry myself to sleep tonight.
Andrew, you should apologize. That
You're
was so mean.
You're a fucking friend.
And after that, go kill yourself.
Oh, Jesus.
Fuck you. That's all I had to say. Go fuck yourself. I'm a horrible friend. Bitch, please, I can show you horrible if I want to.
Don't make me show you me your dick, my dick.
Don't make me, boy. Show you.
Bitch, I got a front tail and I ain't afraid to use it.
Oh shit.
Okay, I really gotta be lenient with this fucking thing. No, I don't.
This is gonna be awesome by the time I'm done.
What are you building?
I got tired of, like, just throwing all my shit into just random chests. So, I'm building a, library of essence. Like, you'd really have to see it to understand what I'm saying. If you get a second, stop over in my dimensional door and I'll show you.
Alright, well...
Is it at your house, by chance?
No, it's over by the quarry.
Does it have a black roof?
No. Do you know where the quarry machine was?
Yes, I'm at it right now.
Just run around on the outside and look for a dimensional
door. I'm over here. Don't jump down there. Oh, you can fly. Good deal.
Oh yeah, that's right. It hisses. Mine it, quick.
Oh, there you go. That's the black roof I was talking about.
Is there a black roof on it?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. There's pieces of black roof.
Ah, fucking gas.
I do it like three high, and then I'm gonna build like a solid thing across the top, do it again up there. But it's gonna look pretty cool by the time I'm done, and I'll have like signs at the end of the row, like this whole row will be cobblestone, this whole row will be this, and this whole row will be, you know, something else as I go. I'm just going off of what I've gotten here.
I'm going to need to charge my jet. Continue creeper hunting.
Continue creeper hunting. Come here, buddy.
Okay, get out. Whew.
Ouch.
Oh, hi, Gast.
Tell people to get out. Not very nice.
Tell myself to get out, because I'm battling a Gast while mining redstone.
Redstone?
There's redstone ore in the nether.
Oh, okay. I was like, I don't understand. How are you finding redstone in the nether?
You're literally just mining redstone ore, and then you have to go back home and smelt it. It's a little bit dumb, but it's not the worst thing possible. Ooh, a gold sword! That was worth the kill.
Not really.
In my mind, it was, because I can actually reverse engineer that at some point and get the gold from it.
Oh, I didn't know you could do that.
This is it. Okay, I'm back. Are you angry at me? You're not angry at me. Alright, how am I doing? Oh god, I'm almost out. Oh shit, this isn't it. Okay. Fuck. Okay.
Really?
There we go, that's it. How many? 334. Okay. Please be. What the fuck? I guess I have no choice now. I gotta fucking go to the Nether Fortress and do that. It's clearly my only option right now. Oh, it's almost out. Oh, damn it, it just ran out. Shit. I really should have marked another portal on my waypoints. Did anyone else mark it at all?
I have not.
Yes.
Well, I've been down there.
You marked it?
I marked it.
Alright, can you press the menu button? Press M for you. I have a different button set for it, but.
Okay. Alright.
If you have a standard setup, it's
alright. Okay, go to waypoints and then click on the arrow until it says waypoints nether.
I have dim and open world.
There should be another if you have one. Set for
well,
the.
I haven't been to the nether.
Can you set?
No.
Okay.
He made a waypoint for the thing you told him to make a waypoint for.
This is not an open server, Mom.
This is not an open server. What?
Someone in my chat. This is not an open server, unfortunately.
I thought you were talking to your mother.
No.
Very lost in that conversation for a second.
Okay. Does anyone want to step through the nether and find out the coordinates for me then?
Yeah, I'll do it.
Alright, thank you. I got it.
Just a second.
Take your time. Actually, don't take your time.
Well,
Fucking hurt. Hurry your ass up.
I'm going as fast as I can.
Not fast enough. Go Sonic fast, damn it.
Yeah.
Good. Hold on. Let me store this gunpowder into.
I would store anything you don't want to explode instantly. Just in case that happens again.
Got no clue. Follows a very linear path, though.
It's thundering out, guys. I can't go anywhere.
No, it's not. There's no precipitation at all here. Where are you? You're not in the same city as me at all. Dumbass.
You're a dumbass.
You're a fucking dumbass. It's raining outside.
I didn't do anything to you. Don't be an asshole.
I can be an asshole.
Okay, I'm coming to the portal.
Okay.
I thought we were friends.
Since when?
Alright. So, C. Negative 15.
Motherfucking chest. What? Aw, you piece of shit.
Are you good to take this waypoint down?
I am not. There's a gas after me. Give me 2 seconds. Of all the times for my pickaxe to break. Alright.
What
happened? Boop. Okay.
I, fell off the platform.
Okay.
Why is there a creeper or a zombie down here?
Alright, I'm ready for the coordinates.
Hold on, I'm currently fighting a zombie. Not a zombie pig. Hold on.
Yes, I see him.
He's gone. Alright, so, the coordinates are... negative 15.
Negative
15.
Oh, wait. Hold up. Negative 15 for X.
Y is 72.
72.
Z is 43.
Okay. Let's see. Okay.
You are gonna like adventure around down here, I would highly suggest making a waypoint.
Okay.
Boop. I have.
Okay.
Just wonder what Andrew's doing down here.
Mining for stuff.
What is this?
The bridge.
Thin bridge.
How am I gonna do this?
I think he put it together to make his way around.
Oh god, the gas. Come here.
Coming to help. I have nothing on me, so I don't think I'm gonna help.
Got him.
Do you have any bullets?
I have nothing on me.
Alright, let's see here.
I thought I might give you my gun, but oh wait, actually, hold on.
Oh, no.
Here, have this. Like,
ignore me.
Okay. The hell do I do with this?
The knife.
Throwing knife.
Okay. We can't get down this way.
I can.
Fuck you. I will just die.
Just dig the... Never mind. It's not a stack.
What? Oh, this is an actual ore. Shit.
What's going on?
Ooh, what's this right here?
I don't know.
What is it? What's it look like? It looks like minerals, but
the
rocks in your way is
72. Shit in that.
Come on.
I hope you don't want this bag, because I'm gonna end up killing myself because I can't get out of here.
Oh shit. just make a tower of nether rock.
Like, I have no...
You guys are in the nether?
Yeah, I can't mine anything either.
Alright.
Well, I guess you're screwed.
Okay, I'm here. No, I'm not. I'm almost there.
I'm here! Look at me now!
I am 18 blocks away from the waypoint. Okay, I'm here. That bridge goes to the Nether Fortress.
Well, I guess you're just screwed then.
Where are you guys?
Alright. I'll just kill myself, it's fine.
There's a pig man on your bridge.
Yeah, I know, let him be. Or kill him, it doesn't matter.
Just walk by him.
It's hard when the bridge is one block long.
I made that so I could establish a point to the next land and get to the Nether Fortress, which is about 600 blocks that way. Yes, shut up, you stupid guest. I don't want your goddamn opinion.
The Nether Fortress?
I did.
You did? Did you find anything good?
I know there was a blaze spawner.
Hmm.
Alright, I came back with some redstone ore. Let me tell you something. Redstone ore is a lot harder to get, because the second you mine it, those motherfucking pigmen go aggro.
Pigmen?
Yeah, they go aggro.
Really?
Yeah. No matter what ore, as long as it's... You can mine netherrack and nether brick and glowstone. They won't aggro. Everything else they will get.
But not their shit.
Yeah.
This is mine. Territorial creatures, and if you hit one of them, they all aggro to you.
Yeah, they're like wolves.
Fun to watch.
Now I'm just waiting on the redstone. Oh my god, this actually feels good to get redstone. Why is redstone so scarce in our world?
What are you talking about? I've been getting plenty of it.
I've been getting jack shit all for redstone.
I don't know. You just don't have good luck. Yeah.
Minecraft just hates.
Probably.
And I'll lend you some of my stone.
But I expect it back. Same form.
What good is that going to do me?
I'll gladly pay you tomorrow for a hamburger today.
Fucking Christ. Alright. For everyone on my stream, I just cleared out chat for visual purposes. It's not meant for anything else, really. Just to help see the video.
I don't like what you're saying.
God.
Be honest, it's okay.
Quinn.
Yeah?
I'm wondering, have you heard about the Rosalina and Luma amiibo?
Yes.
Ah, it's fucking dumb.
What is that?
Okay, well, for Super Smash Bros., for the Wii U and for the 3DS, there's the amiibo for Rosalina and Luma.
Amiibos.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, one person bought a shit ton of Rosalina and Lumas just to hoard them to himself because he hates the character. Literally, he bought it just so nobody else could get it because he absolutely hates the character.
You know,
and it's the dumbest thing.
That's an asshole thing to do in this amiibo economy.
It actually, for anyone that's actually seriously collecting amiibos, it can be a douche thing to do.
Oh my God.
Andrew, somehow your cat got outside.
Yeah, outside. I pushed it outside so the creepers could be scared away.
Apparently it doesn't help with skeletons.
I pushed it back inside.
You motherfucker.
I just pushed it back inside. It's sitting in your living room.
Oh my God. It's almost 4 a.m.
Does it actually scare off the creepers?
It does, actually. It's one of their main functions.
Everything's blown up, all the creepers blew out of his house, but his cat is just sitting there, still in the living room.
Here's the fuck you to you.
No, it'd be even better if it was like, I put my cat on a pedestal, and everything except the pedestal blew up. No, server's restarting.
15 minutes.
We got time.
So, it should just auto-kick everyone.
It does. I've been in here before when that happens.
Okay. Not pleasant.
Shovels.
Alright, I need a pickaxe. Because I don't want to use mine yet.
Let's see, what do I want to make now?
Hey, can I steal some diamonds from you?
Go ahead.
Where are they again?
Where the ingots are.
I found them.
They're labeled for a reason.
You said ingots and such.
That includes...
There's no specificness to this. What the
I have to build it up and then tear it back. Yeah, I have to build it up and then tear it down. In order to get the redstone.
What's the maximum number of blocks that the turtle could take?
I believe
I think
it's
25 by 25.
Yeah, okay. Something like that. I wanted to try 64 by 64. That'd be nice.
Well, I would assume that it would be the same as the excavator.
You'd be guessing wrong, Mesa. I don't know. Try typing in excavate 64 and see what happens. That's my best suggestion.
Fuck!
What'd you forget? Oh.
I made the wrong item.
Oh, God.
Damn it. Well, here's some diamond pickaxes.
What were you trying to make?
Axes. Fuck it. Cunts.
Ah, nice. Alright. I gotta recharge my jetpack.
I cannot believe I did that.
Alright, Kitty.
Like, I'm so
Kitty.
Used to, like, you know, like, oh, I'm gonna do this.
Yeah, I can understand that. Come on, Kitty. Kitty, teleport out here. Cat.
Okay.
Kitty.
Hope to see results.
Kitty. Thank you. Oh, God, you teleported right into the cactus farm. Kitty.
Oh, I'd sleep down.
Okay. Sit you down.
Sleep time.
And then
put her right there. If we can get to a sleep spot.
Oh. Let me slap this into charge first, and then I'll sleep.
Alright. I just wanna... I'm gonna go mine some trees, so...
Okay.
Now that I finally started running out of stuff.
Actually, what wouldn't be a bad idea is you said that we can spawn trees in the dimensional doors, right?
Yeah.
Let's just do a tree dimensional door just filled with rubber trees.
Well, I'm about ready to take out, like, I grabbed, like, 3 diamond axes so I could take out an entire
forest.
Like, there's just this huge, like, tree that is conjoined over in the forest that I've been slowly picking at, so I finally got some pickaxes to try and take it down.
Some pickaxes, not actual axes.
Fuck it, axes, damn it! Fuck you!
Okay, I need... Unbreaking. What do I want on my pickaxe? I already have unbreaking.
It still didn't take out the whole axe.
I guess fortune 3.
There we go. Somebody want to run over and help me real fast?
What'd you do?
All this shit. I'm deleting. I'm using the thing to obviously delete the trees, but I'm trying not to lose anything in the process.
All right.
Let me see if I have diamonds to make a diamond axe.
Well, it's just picking up stuff. Not like you don't have to like actually.
Oh, okay. I can do that. All right.
Yeah. It's just. There's like a forest off to the side there.
Ah, 12. Fuck you.
I know what you're talking about. Oh, there you go.
Fuck!
Hi.
What happened?
I went to go jump on top of the top of a tree and it deleted.
So it's only if you had a jetpack like me.
Shut up. I do have a jetpack, it isn't charged.
You know how to charge it.
I know, I just haven't gotten around to it. That's literally the problem. I just haven't gotten over to do it. Get over here as far as I can. Damn
it! I need 10.
Fuck!
Alright, here, Rob. You spawned at the house, right?
Yeah.
Okay, come into me.
Where are you?
I'm in the house.
You inside?
Yes. Here, take my boots.
Thank you.
But I do want them back when you're done.
Yeah, no problem. Wes, you could actually probably bounce around up there if you want. And delete shit, I can pick up stuff.
Can I make 16? I can only make 11. Find iron.
Now, am I completely covered on fall damage, or is it just some fall damage?
It's probably protected by 50%, I'd say.
Okay.
A significant amount is protected, but not all of it. That's it.
And the MFP.
Alright, so apparently quartz axes do not work. Yeah, alright, so quartz axes are another thing that won't delete everything.
That's dumb.
Well, I don't think it was a part of the original mod.
Fair. That's fair. Alright, there you are. And then iron furnace. Yep.
Well, I'm gonna make an axe to make it quicker.
I can give you one.
I can make one.
Alright, I would suggest making, like an iron or a diamond one, if you're gonna make one.
Actually, no. Fucking come by the house, I have plenty of sapphire, green sapphire, and ruby.
Before you do that, let me try actually deleting something with the set, with, one of those.
It works, I've tried it. It works.
Okay.
I've got 76 sapphire, 54 green sapphire, and 64 ruby. No, my bad. 72 ruby.
There we go.
So, we got the stuff to spare. Okay, well, I need more pine resin again.
Yeah, I haven't gotten any.
Iron furnace, generator, so, LV transformer, tin, I guess. Alright. You know what I will admit is a hard thing to do in Dragon Ball when I'm watching the Dragon Ball?
What?
It's hard to tell who's actually going to be a main antagonist or not, because I only know that the Red Ribbon Army in general is an antagonist, but not who individually is the big bad guy.
The funny thing with the Red Ribbon Army is they're still around in Dragon Ball.